there is an ancient fort dating back to the 14th or 15th century AD in a village called Chennampalli in Thuggali Mandal of Kurnool district, Andhra Pradesh. Over the past 4 to 5 days, we've been noticing some diggings and excavations going on. Upon inquiry with the local people who are present at the site of excavations, it is found that an officer of the rank of RDO Adoni and also local police officials of the ranks of inspectors, sub-inspectors and deputy superintendents of police are present, providing protection to the people who are actually making these excavations. As public representatives of the primary and only opposition party today in the Andhra Pradesh Legislative Assembly, YSRCP, we have approached the collector and asked him as to who is actually doing these excavations. We did not receive a proper reply. And then upon inquiry with the Archaeological Survey of India and State Archaeology Department, we have been told that it is out of their jurisdiction. So automatically the state government and in turn the collector of the district becomes the custodian of this property. And this being very ancient and of a lot of historical importance because of its date from the 15th century or 14th century, built during the Vijayanagar Samraj, we have asked the collector as to, is there any formal order given by the government to do this excavation? What is the purpose of doing these excavations? We did not receive a proper reply. At the same time, when some mining people were present over there and people assumed that it was part of a mining operation, we have also informed the collector that whether it is a state government or central government mining prospecting going on, you require to take a mining permission in the form of a prospecting license, which is not taken. And the state government in turn has not given any written instruction or order to do such excavations. So it is clearly noticed that this is a treasure hunt going on. People are digging a 15th century old fortress for gold, which indirectly has been authorized by the state government of Andhra Pradesh. Look at the surprising part. Authorized by the state government of Andhra Pradesh under oral instructions. Then we ask the district collector as to, if there is oral instruction, who is the person who has given this oral instruction? What is the validity of this oral instruction? What is the authenticity of this oral instruction? And who is going to be accountable for giving this oral instruction of a treasure hunt taking place in broad daylight and also night? And we also ask the collector as to, if this is an oral instruction, you have employed excavators and compressors and lot of labor and there is expenditure involved. So who is paying for this expenditure? Is the government paying for this expenditure? If the government is paying for this expenditure, then you have to have an authorized way of doing it. Look at the blatant way in which a government itself unauthorizedly is actually going about a treasure hunt. So then there was an example given saying that some treasure was located in Srisalam. Then we said, if somebody is excavating for a particular purpose and you come across a treasure, then that becomes the property of the government. But is there an instance of a government itself going on a treasure hunt? So this is how the administration and governance is taking place in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Our, as the primary and the lone representative political party in the Andhra Pradesh legislature today, our concern is, if a government can get down to a level of going to a treasure hunt in a old fortress, what about the other departments? What is going on in the state? Is it governance, administration, or is it some sort of private movie type of enterprise that is going on? This is our concern. We have also written to the Archaeological Survey of India to hand over these premises immediately to prevent such things from taking place, and also the other government departments, upon seeing this, what is the sort of corruption it could lead to? If a government can unauthorizedly give oral instructions to facilitate a treasure hunt, what about the corruption that is taking place in various government departments like irrigation, roads and buildings, etc.? That is our concern.